The Scorpion News is a public forum for student expression. Students make all content decisions and opinions do not necessarily represent those of the HUSD.
Scorpions, it's me, Connor, and look at Brian, all you sophomores in Mr. Max class I thought I'd never make it. The end of semester one is less than 3 weeks away. Be sure to check your grades, talk to your teachers, and get the help you may need to finish the semester strong. Before we get to the announcements, we would like to congratulate Mock Trial on their guilty verdict yesterday. Thank you for representing Scorpion Country well. Are you interested in puzzles and riddles? If so, then be sure to come and check out the new puzzle club next Thursday, December 10th, at lunch in room N7. I wonder what kind of puzzle they do in there. Well, here's our weekly trivia that you can piece together. Good luck, everyone. May the force be with you. And whoever wins, Yoda bomb. Attention seniors, don't forget to submit your FAFSA. Make sure to come to the CCRC at room A6 to get help filing them out and applying. The Career and College Resource Center is open from 7 a.m. to 3:30 p.m. every day to assist you. The annual talent show is this Friday, December 6th. There will be lots of rapping, singing, and saxophone playing at the talent show. We caught up with Caleb Jackaford, the saxophone player on campus, to see how his audition went. Roll the clip.
Hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
Caleb Jackaford.
And what are you going to be doing today?
I'll be playing the air saxophone.
Is that like the air guitar?
Exactly.
All right, well, the stage is yours. Good luck. All right, we're gonna vote. That's a no for me.
That is a no for me too.
You know what?
On every mountain, and swim every ocean. Just to
believe. You can purchase tickets to the talent show from any ASB leadership student, a show contestant, and also at the student store. Pre-sale tickets are only $5 and will increase to $7 at the door the night of the event. While you're at the student store, why don't you buy some water? Wait, did someone say water? Have you ever wondered about the composition of water? Fellow broadcast students Alex and Sam made a segment asking students about H2O and its potential threats to society.
So this week on broadcast, we wanted to focus on more serious topics going on throughout the world. So one of my first topics is safe drinking water. And a recent study conducted in Washington found high amounts of hydrogen in people's very own drinking water. So my question to you is, what can we do as the public to raise awareness about this issue?
We could talk about it, like, because everybody needs to hear about this, like, honestly. Because, like, when people hear, they get passionate about it and they'll, like, start trying to do stuff.
You just need to get it into, like, the right outlets where people are going to hear it. Because if you put it in a certain place where people don't want to hear the news from and they're not going to care about it, it won't matter as much. So, I mean, if you just put it where people want to hear it from. And the other part of it is how it's worded. They need to say it in a way that will make people want to care about it. It's not just going to be, oh, there's hydrogen in the water here. People are going to be like, okay, it doesn't affect me, and go on about their day.
We can post on social media to have the teens know, because in this world nowadays, it's only the teens who create awareness for things like that.
it's just worrying because I got two little sisters, and what if they drink that water? Honestly, yeah. Like any of my family members, and it's very concerning.
So, I asked you, how concerned are you with high amounts of hydrogen in people's drinking water? And I was wondering if you could take, could you take a look at this? Could you tell me the two elements that are in water?
Oh, hydrogen and oxygen. See, the problem is you said there's only one hydrogen in the water. There has to be two. So when there's only one in there, it's not full water. It's hydroxide, and that's poisonous. You don't want that in you. It's pretty bad.
Oh, I'm so dumb.
Are you still concerned about hydrogen?
No. We can't drink hydroxide.
So you're concerned about hydroxide being...
Yeah, we're going to start drinking hydroxide. There's only one hydrogen in the water.
Okay. Preach.
Thank you, Robbie.
You're welcome.
Oh, we'd like to apologize for that technical difficulty. The full video will be up on YouTube when we upload the broadcast later today. Man, that really darkens things up. I guess I'm gonna have to lighten things up back up by going to the Light Club every Wednesday in room E10 during lunch. Congratulations to Mr. Pineda's class. The answer was B.50. Well, that's it for me today's Europeans. I really hope I lit up your day. I'm going to pass it up to my twin brother, co-host for Twins Gaming, older brother, Caleb, for the sports news. Hey, Scorpions, it's your sports host, Caleb, for the week, also known as the Sax Guy. First, I'd like to welcome back our boys basketball team from Hawaii with their win against Rio Grande in the World Tour of Sports Hawaii Thanksgiving event. Congratulations to Tony Singleton for making the Hawaiian Invitational All-Tournament team. We'd also like to congratulate the girls basketball team for winning against Mayfield Citrus Valley. Get out. And congrats to the boys soccer team for winning against Desert Mirage and Adelanto. And lastly, a big congrats to the Class 2020 on the rough and tough win. We caught up on some highlights of the event. Roll the clip. Oh man, that looked rough and tough, ahaha. Good job for everyone participating. Good luck to our boys and girls soccer teams with their matches today against Valley View and King at 5 p.m. And lastly, color guard tryouts are next Tuesday and Thursday in the cafeteria. Go to the band room for more information. Well, that's all for me today, Scorpions. We'll see you next week on our last broadcast of the semester. It's been your host, Caleb Shockford, signing off.
So there's some people in broadcasting that haven't been in front of the camera lately, so today we're forcing them to.
No one is trying that.
So, what are you doing? It's wrong.
That's so awkward.
Wait, can you redo mine?
Hello?
Uno más. No mas. You're in the shop.
It's a grip bar. Grip bar.